Ghana na for penam. Hey, Ghana na for the light meat. Oh, Tom wants to there. Obechia wants to dinner man. You don't know she. You don't know. It is in Ghana you will see tea bread, sugar bread, butter bread, wheat bread, light soup. I said Jehovah Nissi Jireh. Elohim El Shaddai. Jesus is Lord. Help your daughter. This meat was singing hallelujah. Don't sing my Cora. I'm going for suwo. I'm going for suwo. It's more tomatoes with the siso. If I tell you how much I buy them, they will always think you are coming from Lagos or you speak Yoruba or Igbo.
Send us joyful space. Subscribe.
Blessed, welcome back to my channel. My name is Sandra and this is Sandra's Joyful Space. You are welcome once again. Hey, today's video, I am excited. You can tell. Hey, I am very excited to dive into today's video. But before we dive in, if this is your first time you're on this channel, you're coming across my face, I say you are highly welcome. Hey, on this channel, I talk about my experience in Ghana, interracial love, faith, lifestyle, and all that. If that's what you are interested in, please do not forget to hit the red subscribe button. Yes, that button down there, just help me to hit it. Yes, thank you very much. Yeah, so today's video. In fact, let me arrange this my hair well. Let me sit well. Today's video, oh my God, is doing ching 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 ching. Today's video, I'll be talking about things you should expect from Ghana. When you go to Ghana, the things you should expect, and also from Ghanaians. Expect these things very very well. Expect that when you are in Ghana, these things are sure banker. Like na sure banker. You foresee him. In fact, make us a bebre. Let's just dive right into the video because I am already ready. The number one is expect different types of bread. Brodo bre. You will ask me, what is that? I will tell you. It is in Ghana you will see tea bread, sugar bread, butter bread, wheat bread. Which other one again? My Ghanaians, help me to count. Just continue for me in the comment section. Just continue the list for me. When I go to Ghana, my people, I shock it. This one, I was confused. I say, what is this? I went to buy bread, though. What do I know? Sandy going to buy bread. I go to the shop. I said, please, I want to buy bread. But talk, bro, though. At time, I cannot speak Chiyo. I said it in English. I want to buy bread, though. Mm-hmm. Then the woman said, okay, which one, I don't understand. The question I was expecting was like, you know, how much, not which one. So I'm just standing like this. Ma, I don't understand, which one are some? Is it tea bread, butter bread, sugar bread, wheat bread? Hey! I put my hand on my head. Madam, all these are bread. All these ones, they are names of bread. Like, inside this your country. Now, all these ones are they call bread. She said, are you new? I say, madam, I'm very, very new. Very new. Please, enlighten me. Tell me more. Are you saying in this Ghana, you people get different type of bread? She said, yes, let me show you. This one is tea bread. You see the tea bread, no? It's like this. This one is sugar bread. You see the sugar bread, no? It's like this. They have sugar, they do this. You see the butter bread, no? The butter bread, they put butter, they do this. You see the wheat bread, no? They do this. I say, You don't mean it. Not only that, it didn't stop there. She now gave me the biggest shocker. When I now said, okay, ma, I will go for the sugar bread because I was not sure of the other ones. I said, okay, let me go for sugar bread. At least it will be sweet. When I hear the word sugar, I said, let me go for the sweet one. I've not tasted the others to be safe. She now said, okay, how much? Now said, one CD. I can't remember actually how much. I said, I think one CD or so. Then she was like, okay. The next thing I saw, this woman brought knife. She was dividing the bread. I say, madam, wait, what is good? Why are you dividing my bread now? I say I want to buy bread. We are cutting. Why are you dividing my bread? She said, I have to one city here. Obechia one city na ma. You don't know she. You don't know. So that is how I now saw that in Ghana, not only do they have different bread, but they divide that for you. If you want to even use your coins, your 50 pesos, they will cut it for you. They will give it to you according to, you know, your pockets, according to what you can afford. Like, they will give it to you. And it is good though. I like it very, very well. At least any amount of money you have, if you are hungry, you can buy bread. Yes, now you can buy bread though. Feel where I'm coming from. Yes, when you want to go and buy bread, they have already tied the bread and portioned it according to the prices. There is no time to go and be cutting bread in the shop. You want to buy 70 naira bread, it is there. They have tied it. Madam, which one are 70 naira bread, 80 naira bread, 100 naira bread? Which one do they buy? No time to go there. Mm-mm. Except maybe on some occasions, I've seen those people who hawk, you know, bread and tea. I'm not really too sure, but I think those people who hawk the bread and tea, sometimes they cut the bread and sell. It's not so common, I'm not really sure. I think maybe in Lagos, this is a bit of a thing. Those who hawk the tea and bread in the morning, I think they cut the bread. But in a normal shop, like where they sell bread, please, they have, you know, packaged it according to the number two thing you should expect. Hey, this one you should expect it well. Hey, Ghana for Penam. Hey, Ghana for Penam, they like meat. Hey, Ghana for, they like meat. They like meat well. You ask me, what is it? I will tell you. Hey, when I go to Ghana, people of God, I saw someone eating fufu and light soup. You know, in the Asanka. Hey, if you see the meat the person used to decorate, that light soup, I said, Jehovah Nissi Jireh. Elohim El Shaddai, Jesus is Lord. Help your daughter. People of God, this one is not small matter. This meat was singing hallelujah. I said, madam, I said, wahoo, this is for one person or for three people or for five people. It's for one person, no. Two people for the year, three people for what? And when this lady want to serve me, behold, my Asanka was also looking, you know, very sumptuous and filled with a lot of meat. I say, blood of Jesus. Is this for only Sunday alone? Or there are four people coming to join me? She said, oh, it's for you, oh sister. I said, all this meat for me. She said, yes. I said, blood of Jesus. This one I not eat before me, Munda. I've not seen this one before. For the way. I said, oh, so this is how people serve food here in Ghana. Then you can give one person 7, 8, 9 meat. Like, a normal thing where I come from. Please. The plate no they heap like that with me too. It's just 2-3 meat and you go. When they want to serve an adult, yes, there can be 2-3 meat in the plate. It's okay, it's normal. Yes, we have some exceptions where some people like actually like meat and they can feed their plate. I will put a plate of what a Nigerian normal, you know, plate will be looking like. And I will not put a plate of, you know, a Ghanaian normal plate is looking like. Enjoyment be what? Enjoyment they Ghana well. You go chop. In fact, hey, you enjoy yourself. You enjoy yourself well. Then the number three things you should expect from Ghana and Ghanaians is, Ntos ni mekora. Amu fosu wo. If you don't want to buy, you don't want to buy. If you will buy, you buy. Nobody they force you. They are not rude though. Mm-mm. Don't get me wrong. Let me break it down for you. When in the Ghanaian market, you are doing your normal shopping. Then you walk up to the Ntos seller, you know. You say you want to buy tomatoes and pepper. Then you say, please, how much is the tomatoes and pepper? 10 cedis, oh sister, 10 cedis. 10 cedis is too much now. You don't say 7 cedis. No, it's 10 cedis last. And this one is 8 cedis. If you want this one, it's 8 cedis. I can give you for 8 cedis. This one too is 5 cedis. If you want, I can give you this one 5 cedis. But this one, no, is 10 cedis. Sister. Pastor, 7 cedis, sell it for me now. Is this one I want to buy? This one, please now, sell this one for me, 7 cedis. I don't want the one for 5 cedis. Is this 10 cedis one that I want? But please, sell it for me, 7 cedis. Sister, no, I cannot. This one, no, is 10 cedis last, like 10 cedis last. If this one you want to buy, I can give you 8 cedis. And this one, 5 cedis. But this one, no, is 10 cedis last. And that is it. Yes, that is it. They don't talk more than that. After that conversation, after giving you the information, case closed, bargain finish. They don't push further again. They don't probe further. They don't drag you. They don't force you. They don't try to convince you. They don't try to impress you. They don't try any further. They have told you how they are selling it. If you want to buy, then it is now left for you to make your decision. You buy or you not buy. Yes, yo. Then they will now keep quiet and be looking at you. When they are looking at you, you know, it means that, ah, sister, oh yeah, which one are you buying? Then you will now stand there and decide if you will buy any of them or you go. And when you are going to, nobody come and drag you back that, hey, you must buy. You will go your go. Nobody will disturb you. But where are you coming from? Hey! People of God, it's not like that though. You want to buy tomatoes? Let me give you the setting. Mother, I want to buy tomatoes, so I get tomatoes, fresh tomatoes. And this morning, I just go bring these tomatoes, come with fresh one. And now you'll be the first customer who just come today. Ah, customer. As you know, I always do you well. So trust me, today I go do you well. Ah, you go do me well, no. Trust me before now. I'm gonna do you well. I'm gonna show you one buy. How much for this one? Ah, now 1,000 naira, my sister. Madam, you don't come again. Which one be 1,000 naira? Not be 500 naira. When tomatoes come dear like that? Ah, my sister, tomatoes don't dear. You not hear? Hey, they don't increase tomatoes. Not be small matter where they grow so. So you never hear when I go bush market this morning to buy tomatoes. If you see price when I take buy these tomatoes where they grow so, these small tomatoes where they see so. If I tell you how much I buy them, in fact you go pity me. No gain. I know they make one gain. One gain I know they make. I use the concept for selling. I know they make gain, no matter. Now 1,000 naira, I know go fish it to you. I know go fish it. You know me. And today they sell for you. I know go fish it to you. Ah, wow. You don't come again. Oh yeah, may I give you 800 naira? You know, let me sell. If you go, let me drive for seller for you. Now 1,000 naira. See this tomato with the sisu. For this life, now it fresh pass. Now today tomatoes now I don't bring a fresh one. So I know go feel you. If you go, let me. I for don't reduce that. Now today, not be today. I know you now. This is how they talk. I for don't reduce that. Not be now. I beg, just go out for me 800. Now 800 I get. I beg. You know, work. Oh, now 1,000 naira. Okay, now I go. They go. They go. So you don't go buy these fresh tomatoes. It's fresh well no. Oh yeah, come, make I reduce 100 naira for you. Yeah, come, go reduce 100 naira. Come. Now 800 I get, so I don't get 900. Oh yeah, come, I go sell that for you. Oh yeah, come, make I sell that for you. Customer cost I want for you. Small tea don't best, so they go. So they do market. Oh yeah, come, I sell that for you. Be my customer now. That is a typical Nigerian market. For you. So if you think that those are the my cousin, I'll come and be talking all this long story. They don't have time for long story. They will just tell you short. If you are finding those people that will cajole you small, and maybe those boys that are selling, you know, the folks or I don't know, all those things on the street, the shoes, the trousers, perhaps they will be cajoling you. But those that they don't have time for that. Yes. And the fourth thing you should expect from Ghana and Ghanaians is if you are going to buy pap, abi coco. Hausa Coco. I say pap because of my Nigerian people. Yes. Just prepare yourself. You might not see this one coming. Like, it will just hit you. Bam! You might not see it coming. You will say, what am I talking about? Let me just give you the details. Yes. So, my first time going to buy Hausa Coco in Ghana. In Nigeria, we have what we call pap and akara. And in the morning, just like they say, Hausa Coco and Kose. That's how you see, you know, pap and akara everywhere. Just on the streets, as you are going to work, to school, you can just buy it, you know, and eat along the way. It's just very common. So I'm used to this, you know, pap and akara, and I like it. And in fact, not only like, I love it a lot. So when I saw Hausa Coco and Kose, I said, ah, for the weird, pap day year, like akara day year. What are you going to tell me? You cannot tell me anything. What are you going to tell me? Like, I for represent. So that is how I was really excited though. I run quickly because I've been passing, I've been seeing people buying. I've already, you know, been eyeing that, this thing here, I have to taste it. So when I, you know, confirm that really, this is like, you know, pap and akara, I say, today is that day, amen, the day of the Lord, amen. Today is that day, amen, the day of the Lord, amen. My people, I ran there quickly. When I go there, I say, madam, I for buy. I for buy tete. And the woman say, okay, how much? I told her. But the color was different because our own pap that I'm used to is very white. But this one was kind of, you know, darker in color. I'll put a picture of what, you know, the Nigerian pap look like, and the Hausa cocoa I'm talking about, the Ghanaian Hausa cocoa I'm talking about. But I didn't worry, like, who says, like, it must be white? Is there any law? There's no law that says it has to be white. So any color is good. As far as it's pap, I will buy. I actually thought the taste would be, you know, very similar, like, very similar. So I bought my Hausa cocoa and my kose. I got home that day. Hey, hey. The excitement was on another level. I was overjoyous. My sister said, what have you gone to buy? I said, it's pap and akara. She said, are you sure it's pap and akara? Where do you see it? I said, that woman that I've been selling along the street when we used to pass here, pass here. She said, I know it. That one that people have said, yes, that place people used to go. Are you sure it's akara and akamu? I said, trust me now. I don't know akara and akamu. Come and taste. Let's eat. My sister said, yes, yo, we for eat. That is how we pour it in the plate. You know, we sit on the floor, we spread out our legs out so that, you know, fresh air can enter every part of our body because it's very hot. When we are eating it, you'll be sweating. So that all the sweat we see, we have to pass out. And so we just unfan. Everywhere was, you know, ventilated so that we can eat well, my people. Immediately, I just take one spoon like this, you know, straight into my mouth. Hey! Yeah. I'm like, what is that? Ooh, why is it peppish like this? Which day pap can they get pepper? What is this? I mean, not be pap I buy. Oh, this is not pap. I was confused. I said, I didn't know that Hausa cocoa is peppish. I was thinking that it's the same pap from my country that when you put it in your mouth, it just, you know, cool, just going down, like you just be tasting, you know, the sweet taste. There is no pepper at all. There is no pepperish feeling at all in the pap from my country. So for me, this was like, I was like, this one too. So I started to taste the kose. Kose, actually, I loved it the first time I tasted it. It didn't taste actually like akara, like the one from my country, but it was very nice. Like, immediately I tasted it, I was like, this one enter. I ran off Hausa cocoa for a long time. But when I got to school, you know, as students, hurry to class, you don't get to eat breakfast quickly and all that. I decided to give it a try again because, you know, as students, I don't have an option. So I decided to give it a try again, and again, and again, and again. Before you know it, I fell in love. Like, Hausa cocoa be what? Ide bi keke. Hausa cocoa de enter. Like, ide enter. No, let me go think about it because I'm already missing Hausa cocoa. So, in fact. And I think in the northern part of Nigeria, I think they also sell this type of cocoa. I think so. I'm not so sure, but I think so. But because I didn't grow in the northern part of Nigeria, I'm not used to it. I'm not used to, like, you know, this type of cocoa. That's why it was a bit of it. So to some Nigerians, it might not be kind of, you know, anything new. So my last point for this video is, just know that when you meet a Ghanaian, for sure, when you guys are having a conversation, they will say, are you from Lagos? Then you're like, no, I'm not from Lagos. I'm coming from Delta State. So you are Yoruba? They will always think you are coming from Lagos or you speak Yoruba or Igbo. That's the only thing they will ask you. You know that one. You're on your own. You're just on your own. If you are not from Lagos, you don't speak Yoruba, you don't speak Igbo. Hey, which one are you now? Like, where exactly are you now coming from? Like, please come closer. Where are you from? Where exactly are you from? You're not looking at you. Delta State. Where is that? Hey, it's the southern part of Nigeria. You know we have the northern, the eastern, the... in which language do people speak? And I tell them, we speak Urobo. We also have this. Now we're sending it to them. I didn't know. I only know Igbo, Yoruba. I know those ones well. And they know Lagos. They know Port Harcourt. They're going to be counting this for you like that. Anyway, you cannot blame them. They are not from Nigeria. I don't expect them to know every state and every language in Nigeria. Yeah. Don't just expect them to know everything. The same way, me too. I don't know every state in Ghana. If I came to Ghana, it's only Accra I know. Accra. Yes, I knew that perhaps there will be other places. But please, if I see a Ghanaian before I came to Ghana, it's only Accra I know. And also the language. I think the Ghanaians are even better. They even know Yoruba and Igbo. Me, I don't even know which one they were speaking. I don't even know Chi. I didn't even know that their language was called Chibi, because that time I was quite young. I came to Ghana like fresh out of secondary school, so I really, like, you know, not read or really got to know much about Ghanaians before I came to Ghana. So I only just know that Ghana, Accra, that's it, like, that's all. Language, more, no, like, I don't know anything. So they even tried. And why I'm telling you this, so that if you are in Nigeria, you come, then expect them to know that they should know where you are coming from. They should know that you are coming from Calabar, you are coming from here. Don't expect them to know. They will always first of all ask you if you are from Lagos, you speak Yoruba, or you speak Igbo. Yes, that's what they will ask you. That's where they know, oh, you are from Port Harcourt. Yeah. And you cannot blame them. Not only they will come. We too, we don't know much about them before we came to their country. So it's vice versa. So guys, that is the things you should expect from Ghanaians. When you're going to Ghana, you will just expect these things. If you want a part 2 of this video, just comment down below. Part 2 as it day hot. And trust your sister to deliver as it day hot. So guys, if you have watched to this point, I say thank you. And if this is the first time you're coming across my face, across this channel, I say you are welcome. Please do not forget to hit the subscribe button and hit notification bell so that you'll be notified anytime I post any new video. And to my returning subscribers, we for what? We for dance. My blessed people. Thank you all for always coming back to watch your girl. Thank you for your love, your support. I do not take you all for granted. See you all in my next video. Bye.